Multi-selection with checkboxes is a very common design pattern. Many workflows start with us selecting a group of records and then do some batch processes on them. I'm sure many of you have your own ways of implementing this. Welcome back to the channel. This is Wei Hao at Direct Impact Solutions. Today, I'll show you my way of implementing a multi-selection pattern without any scripting. So how do we start? Well, we start with checkboxes. On this layout, we have a portal pointing to a contact table. So we will start by creating a global field in the contact table and call it selected contact IDs. As its name suggests, we will use this field to store all the selected contact records' primary keys, which is usually the goal of multi-selection. There are two reasons we made it a global field. First, modifying a global field won't lock the record. So when we are selecting records, other users can still do data entry as needed. Second, for a hosted file, a global field's value is session-based, meaning what I selected doesn't interfere with other user sessions. So we can all use the same feature at the same time, making it multi-user friendly. I'm going to add the global field to the portal as a checkbox, as well as to the body part as a text field, so we can see the values inside. Now that we have the field to store the result, the next step is to build a mechanism so that when I check a checkbox, the records IDs gets inserted into the global field we just created. We can easily do this with script triggers. However, I don't want to use scripts. So I will use a related value list to do it. Before we create the value list, we will need to create a new relationship. Let's open the relationship graph. I'll add another TO based on the contact table after the TO we use in the portal. For this new TO, we will connect it to the portal TO using the primary key of the contact table. Some of you might have figured out what I'm trying to do here. If not, please continue to watch this video. With this relationship, let's create our value list. It will be a related value list. For the field display, we will use the primary key from the TO we just created. As for the starting context, let's choose our portal TO. After saving this value list, we will attach it to the global field checkbox we created. Here, I'm going to show the value of the checkbox for a bit. As you can see, for each checkbox in the portal, we are evaluating from the context of the portal TO and looking at a related contact record that matches our current record by the primary key. This value list will always return the current contact's primary key. And for checkbox object, if you check it, it will automatically insert the value of the checkbox to the end of the field. And if you uncheck it, it will remove that value. So let's shorten the checkbox to the point that we don't see its value anymore, and we are left with just the checkbox part. That's it. Let's see this in action. For ease of verifying the result, I'm going to display the primary key of the contact in the portal. When I select this record, you can see its ID is added to the global field. Then when I select another record, the newly selected record's ID is inserted to the bottom of the field. Now, if I deselect the first record, its ID gets removed from the field. Pretty neat. I demoed this using a portal, but you can use the same technique on a list as well. Just be mindful about the starting context of your new TO as well as your related value list. That's the end of this video. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. We publish FileMaker videos every week. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.